हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ कीतन एम पटेल फ्रॉम महात्मा गांधी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर नवसारी। माय डिपार्टमेंट इज इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एंड सब्जेक्ट इज डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट थर्ड ईयर फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर। आवर टॉपिक इज इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट चैप्टर नंबर वन। हियर दिस इज सिलेबस कंटेंट, flow of contents, understanding disasters, understanding the concept and definitions of disaster. What is disaster? Disasters management, what is hazard, vulnerability. Disaster occur when hazards meet vulnerability. Classifications of disasters, natural disasters and man-made disasters. First, the introduction of understanding the disasters. Okay. A disaster is a result of hazards impact on the society, a serious disruption of the functioning of a community or a society causing widespread human, material, economic or environmental losses which exceed the ability of the affected community or society to cope using its own resources. Okay, so disaster is an event or series of events which gives rise to causalists and damage or loss of properties, infrastructure, environment, essential service or means of livelihood on such a scale which is beyond the normal capacity of the affected community or society to cope with. Disaster is also sometimes described as catastrophic situations in which the normal pattern of life or ecosystems has been disrupted and extraordinary emergency interventions are required to save and preserve lives and or the environmental. UN define disasters as the occurrence of sudden or major misfortune which disrupts the basic fabric and normal functioning of the society or community. An occurrence causes damage, illogical disruptions, loss of human life, deterioration of health and health services on a scale sufficient to warrant an extraordinary response from outside the affected community or area. By WHO? WHO means World Health Organizations. Disasters can be defined as an occurrence, either nature or man-made, that causes human suffering and creates human needs that victim cannot alive without assistance. By American Red Cross. Disaster management. What is disaster management? The body of policy and administrative decisions and operational activities that pertain to various stages of a disaster at all levels. An applied science which seeks by systematic observation and analysis of disasters to improve measure relating to prevention, emergency response, recovery and mitigations, and encompasses all aspects of planning for and responding to disasters, including both pre and post disaster activity. In disasters, there are a number of various points, like first, water and climate related disasters. In water and climate related disasters, first, flood and drainage management, cyclones, tornadoes and hurricanes, hailstorm, cloud burst, heat wave and cold wave, snow avalanches, drought, sea erosions, thunder and lightning, tsunami, etc. In geological related disasters, the landslides and mud flows, earthquakes, dam failure, dam burst, minor fires. In chemical and industrial nuclear related disasters, like chemical industrial disasters, nuclear disasters. In accidental related disasters, like forest fire, urban fire, mine flooding, oil spills, major building collapse, serial bomb blast, festival related disasters, electrical disasters and fires, air, road and rail accidents, boat capsizing, village fire, in biologically related disasters like biological disasters and epidemics, pest attacks, cattle epidemics, flood, food poisoning. So number of hazards in a disasters management. In a continuous and integrated process of planning, organizing, coordinating and implementing measures which are necessary or expedient for first prevention of danger or threat of any disasters, reduction of risk of any disaster or its severity or consequences, capacity building, preparedness to deal with any disasters, prompt response to any threatening disaster situation or disasters, assessing the severity or magnitude of effects of any disasters, evacuations, rescue and relief, rehabilitation and reconstructions. It's a factor of the disaster management. Now, what is hazard? Okay, any phenomenon that has the potential to cause disruption or damage to people and their environment. A hazard is a natural event while the disaster is its consequence. A hazard is a perceived natural event which threatens both life and property. A disaster is a realization of this hazard by John Vito. When hazard involves elements of risk, vulnerabilities and capacities, they can turn into disasters. So hazards may be inevitable, but disasters can be prevented. Okay. In hazards may be defined as a dangerous condition or event that threat or have the potential for causing injury to life or damage to property or the environment. The word hazards own its origin to word hazard, an old French and azahar, in Arabic meaning chance or luck. So hazards can be grouped into two broad categories, namely natural and man-made. Natural hazards means, what is natural hazards? Natural hazards are hazards which are caused because of natural phenomena, like hazards with meteorological, geological or even biological origin. Examples of natural hazards are cyclone, tsunami, earthquake and volcanic eruptions, which are exclusively of natural origin. Landslides, floods, drought, fire are socio-natural hazards, since their causes are both natural and man-made. For example, flooding may be caused because of heavy rain, landslide or blocking of drain with human waste. Okay, and other is man-made hazards are hazards which are due to human negligence. Man-made hazards are associated with industries or energy generation facilities and include explosions, leakage of toxic waste, pollutions, dam failure, war or civil strife, etc. The list of hazards is very long. Many occur frequently while others take place occasionally. On the basis of their genesis, they can be categorized as follow. First, geological hazards like earthquake, landslide, tsunami, dump burst, volcanic eruptions, mine fire. Okay, water and climate hazards in tropical cyclone, cloud burst, tornado and hurricane, landslide, flood, heat and cold wave, drought, snow avalanche, hailstorm, sea erosion. In environmental hazards, environmental pollution, disinfections, deforestation, pest infection. In biological, human animal epidemics, food poisoning, pest attacks, weapons of mass destruction, etc. In also chemical and industrial and nuclear accidents, in chemical disasters, industrial disasters, oil spills, fire, nuclear. In accidents related, like a boat, road, train accident, air crash, rural, urban fires, bomb, serial bomb blast, forest fire, building collapse, electric accidents, festival related disasters, mine flooding. there are number of hazards, vulnerability, the property propensity of things to be damaged by a hazard. Okay, in vulnerability means is a high or low depend upon the factor with related this point. Vulnerability may be defined as the extent to which a community, structure, services or geographic area is likely to be damaged or disruptive by the impact of particular hazard on account of their nature, construction and proximity of to hazards, terrain or a disaster prone area. Simple, vulnerability means internal weakness or damages. Okay, there are many aspects of vulnerability arising from various physical, social, economical and environmental factors. Example, like poor design and construction of buildings, inadequate protection of assets, lack of public information and awareness, limited official recognition of risk and preparedness measures. So vulnerability, so in the figure, vulnerability is a hazard into capacity of society to withstand. Okay, the factor considered while considering vulnerability are impact of human life, effect on environment, damage to property or structure. Disasters occurs when hazards meet vulnerability. Okay, here also you can see that the disasters is a risk equal to hazard plus vulnerability. Okay, and the progressions of vulnerability is a root causes, dynamic pressures, unsafe conditions, and this is hazards. Both are not prevented. Okay, in root causes, limited access to power, structure, resources, and ideologies is political systems, economic and system. In dynamic pressures, lack of local institute training, appropriate skills, local investment, local market, media freedom, ethical standards in public life. And macro forces is rapid population's growth, rapid urbanization, arms expenditure, debt repayments, deforestation, decline in soil productivity, etc. And unsafe conditions is fragile physical environmental, dangerous locations, unprotected building and infrastructure, fragile local economy, livelihoods at risk, low income levels, vulnerable society, special group at risk, public action, lack of preparedness, endemic disease. Okay, and hazards means earthquake, high winds, hurricane, cyclone, dolphin, flood, typhoon, volcanic eruptions, landslides, drought, virus, bacteria, pest, fire, chemical, radiation, armed conflicts. Okay, now in 2019, the COVID-19 is also shown in picture. Okay, it is come from Wuhan, China. Okay, and all world is affected by the COVID-19. Okay, nowadays it is very dangerous for human life. Okay, so COVID-19 virus is a one type of hazards. Okay, now the China and India war, it's also is a hazards. Okay, it is a man-made disasters. So this is dangerous for both country, human life. Okay, in classification of disasters, the two natural disasters and second man-made disasters. In natural disasters, the meteorological, topographical and environmental, and man-made disasters is technological, industrial and warfare. In natural disasters, the meteorological disasters, topological disaster and environmental disasters. Meteorological disaster is floods, tsunami, cyclone, hurricane, typhoon, snowstorm, blizzard, hailstorm, etc. In topological disaster is earthquake, volcanic eruptions, landslides and avalanches, asteroids and limnic eruptions. Environmental disasters is global warming, southern oscillations, ozone depressions, UVB radiations, solar flare. And man-made disasters is technological, industrial and warfare. In technological, transfer failure, public place failure, fire. In industrial, chemical spills, radioactive spills. In warfare, war, terrorism, internal conflicts, civil unrest, CVRNP. So, disaster is a man-made and natural. Okay. India has been vulnerable in varying degree to large number of natural as well as man-made disaster on occurrence of its unique geoclimate and socio-economic conditions. It is highly vulnerable to flood, drought, cyclone, earthquake, landslide, avalanche, and forest fire. Out of 35 states, the union territory in the country, 27 of them are disaster prone. Almost 59% of land area is vulnerable to earthquake. 12% land area is prone to flood and river erosions. 8% land area is prone to cyclone. Of the 7,516 km long coastline, close to 5,700 km is prone to cyclone and tsunami. 68% of cultivable area is vulnerable to drought. Hilly area are a risk from the landslides and avalanches. So about 25% of the total geographical area of India is prone to landslides. Brahmaputra and Gangetic basins are most flood prone area. Northwest region of west flowing river Krishna, Kaveri and Mahanadi are other flood prone area. Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Orissa, West Bengal and Pondicherry on east coast and Gujarat on the west coast are more prone to cyclones. Cyclone occurs in the month of May, June and October, November with their primary peaks in November and secondary peaks in May. 68% of the cultivated area in the country is vulnerable to drought. Out of this, 33% chronical drought prone, receiving rainfall less than 750 mm per annum. 35% of drought prone area receives rainfall between 750 to 1125 mm per annum. So entire Himalayas, North Asian regions, Western Ghats are predominantly affected by the landslides. Okay, so natural and man-made are affect the man and its property. Okay, then what are the contributing factor of vulnerability? Contributing factor to vulnerability is first support infrastructure, habitat or building sector, demographic pressures, deforestation, faulty agriculture practice, dam and reservoir, climate change, industrialization and urbanization, etc. Okay, so our subject disaster management is a wonderful subject to know about our country's problems, okay, like hazards, vulnerability and disasters. Okay, this is a GTU paper questions. It is a define the term disaster and describe various phases of disasters in 3 marks. What do you mean by terms hazards and vulnerability? 2 marks is the definitions. Give classification of different types of disasters, 7 or 3 marks. And differentiate between natural disaster and man-made disaster. It is a 4 marks. So, it is important for you. Okay? Thank you.